Mother, he's half naked.
Welcome to Class Notes. Okay, so this week we're looking at 1956's The King and I, which was originally a Rodgers and Hammerstein show, which was originally a movie made back in the 40s, which was originally a book, which was originally the diaries of a woman named Anna something or other. I forget her last name. This film was directed by Walter Lang, produced by Daryl F. Zanuck and Charles Brackett, and stars Yul Brynner, Deborah Kerr, Rita Moreno, Carlos Riva, and Terry Saunders. All right, so there's this lady named Anna, and she was hired by the King of Siam to be the teacher to his children. So she's come all the way from England, and then she's like, where's the house you promised me? In the letter where I agreed to do this, he said you was gonna give me a house. And he says, no, I have a palace. Staying in the palace is an honor. Right as she's arriving there, he gets a woman from Burma. Plot twist, it's Rita Moreno with a heavy cat eye and her Mexican lover. You know, they long to be each other in any way. So, you know, the Anna, she does it. She's gonna turn around and get on the boat because she wasn't being given her house. She wants the contract to be honored. But then the king, he emotionally blackmails her with his children. He marches like 16, no. There's tension, there's arguing between them, and then far off in some place or other, the enemies of the king are lying to the British about how he's incompetent and barbaric. But then she helps them figure out, okay, we'll have a gala, and you'll convince them that you're classy and civilized and crazy and sexy and cool like TLC. Tup Tim, you know, the Rita Moreno and Cat Eye, she puts on this big play that she's written based on Uncle Tom's Cabin. The British people love it. They stand up as like, encore, encore, Arthur! Arthur! Plot twist, Tupton and her Burmese lover have fled. He snuck in with the taxi drivers. And so the king, you know, he's very pleased. It's a success. And then he and Anna, they dance furiously and passionately. And they're very uncomfortable with the energy that they've created in the studio. And then the guards come back in with Tupton in chains and her Burmese lover, who's actually Mexican, drowned in the river. So he says, you know what? I'm gonna beat this woman. And Anna says, I don't think you are. But he can't do it, and he's very stricken. He's broken, and the prime minister is like, you've destroyed him. I wish you would never come to Siam. And she's like, so do I. His favorite wife, who gave birth to the crown prince, Lady Tiang, this is Terry Saunders, she comes in, and she's like, speak to him, please. He's dying. She goes to his deathbed, and he's like, and you know, oh, so you're leaving. And she says, yes, I cannot sit here where there is no truth or trust or honor. And then his children march in, and they're weeping and they're sad. They love Miss Anna. They sang an entire song about, you know, getting to know you, getting to know all. It was about the beauty of multiculturalism. They don't even care about their father. They just want Anna to stay. Like one of the little girls, she steps forward. She has practiced a speech in English, and she says, please don't leave me. Right before he dies, because he dies, but that's how the movie ends. He drops dead. Well, not drops, he's on a futon. It's a story of coming to understand each other. Interesting facts about this movie. It was really successful. It won 5 Oscars for Best Actor, Best Costume Design, Best Production Design, Best Sound Mixing, and Best Original Musical, which I guess there was such a high quantity of them back in the 50s that was still a category. Yul Brynner, the guy that played the King of Siam in this movie, wasn't actually Asian. He was Russian. He originated the role of the king on Broadway. Legend has it that, you know, he went in and he sat in the middle of a stage with a guitar and screamed. And Rodgers and Hammerstein were like, this is it. Yul Brynner had lung cancer, so he had to have one of his lungs removed. Between takes, he had to go get on an oxygen mask because he was doing that on half capacity. And Deborah Kerr, she had on that real big hoop skirt. Apparently, like, the hoops were made of metal or something. And so the entire time, they were bashing up against her legs and bruising her really, really bad. All right, everybody, thanks for watching yet another fun, fantastical, feel-good episode of Clef Notes. Tune in next week where I will finally watch something that is not Rodgers and Hammerstein. Don't forget to press, click, comment, like, buttons down below. You know what we did last week. Bye!